young pastor who stood in front of us, who was ready to give a sermon, and it had gotten particularly cold outside, and the snow had been blowing, and that morning he got into the church, and in come one farmer. And he sat down in the pew. Nobody else showed up. The young preacher says, what do you want to do? Farmer says, well, only one cow shows up to the barn still feeding. So the young minister, he pulls out and he says, okie dokie. And they sang all the hymns, they did all the prayers, they did all the praises, and up and down, he gave the full sermon, the whole nine yards. And when it was all over, he looked at the farmer and says, well, what did you think? And the farmer said, well, when that cow shows up, I feed it, but I don't give it the whole bale. So I am just thankful that all of you have come this morning, and that we are going to worship the Lord today, and hopefully things just a little warmer for folks. Great to have Kyle and Jasmine with us, and Baby, and it's just a wonderful morning to celebrate the Lord. Bev said that she's going to do a signature homestyle party on the 6th of January. Yes. That's going to be 11 o'clock.
11, and it's in the bulletin at 2, but we've switched it to 11.
Right. Make it more of a brunch hour at 11. And so you're invited to come in your PJs.
In your PJs, like. Yep. It's a PJ party.
Right. Everybody not the negligee, not the negligee, yeah. But PJs. Okay,
guys.
PJ party. Right. PJ party. And
no tea time.
There's no tea time this week. And we are having a covered dish downstairs. We're scheduled to do it. So you're invited to go downstairs after church. If you didn't bring anything, we've got sandwiches and casseroles and
sauerkraut
kielbasa. So can't beat that, guys. Yes, Jane.
Tuesday isn't on here. Are we on?
Yeah, we got one more book study. So yes, Tuesday we are doing a book study from 11 to 11 to 1. Yep. Any others? Let's begin our worship service and bring forth the light. Sing together our opening hymn, Good Christian Friends Rejoice, number 224.
Amen. would you join me in the call to worship? Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord arises upon you.
We have received in faith that which you, O Lord, have promised.
Emmanuel, God with us, God is us, revealed to us.
Our souls rejoice in the salvation of the Lord.
The Lord will be our everlasting light and glory.
Praise and glory be to you, now and forevermore.
Please join me in the invocation.
O Lord God, you have heaven and earth with your presence, and your eyes have watched over all from the foundation. We have heard the distant sound of your voice in prophets and apostles from long ago. But we are our ear, so are our hearing. Our eyes are dim and cannot see. Come near, Lord, and touch us with your presence. Lay your hand upon our hearts to bring forth your grace. Amen.
I will be reading today from Luke chapter 2, verses 22 through 40. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses had been completed, Joseph and Mary took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male is to be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer a sacrifice in keeping with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of doves or a pair of young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consecration of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Christ. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child, Jesus, to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you now dismiss your servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people, a light of revelation to the Gentiles and to the glory of your people of Israel. The child's father and mother were marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too. There was also a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was very old, and she had lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, and then was with him until she was 84. She never left the temple but worshiped days and nights, fasting and praying. Coming up to them at the very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. When Mary and Joseph had done everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong, and he was filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was upon him. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
This time we have our children's vote.